Again, the details here, the track a little bit different on the final couple of hours as it approaches Jacksonville. The strength, no different from 8 o'clock, though. 115 miles an hour. That makes it a Category 3 hurricane, major hurricane, with gust over 140 miles an hour. Keep watching that. Just, you know, get up tomorrow morning. You're watching Rich, watching Mark. You're also going to watch the pressure to see if that number is going down. Lower the pressure, the worse things are, because pressure drops and the winds go up, and of course that means more damage. Moving to the northwest at about what we figured around 10 miles an hour, that's the expected track, as you can see, going just up the coast and just offshore. It now appears again a Category 3 hurricane. That's a major hurricane, will be just off our coast and then heading on just along the Georgia coastline. This increases the impact, by the way, along the Georgia coastal counties, McIntosh, Glenn, Camden counties. All right, breaking it down a little bit more for you. That is the latest. 1 o'clock in the morning, tomorrow morning, about 2 hours from now, right over the Bahamas and heading on off towards the northwest. It appears now that this 55-mile-an-hour ring, that's what the green stands for. By the way, if you're wondering, why don't you show blue and green or red for something like the eye of the hurricane? Well, the model can't resolve those smaller features, and this eye is particularly small right now. I believe, as the model's going to show you here, that eye is going to expand outward. The eye will have winds right around there, close to about 115 to 130 miles an hour, because it goes Category 4, and it's a Category 4 that goes into where about Cocoa Beach, and then it goes up the coast, and it does go up the coast. It maintains its strength, and that's the serious nature of this storm. And remember I said the final few hours of the track was more off the coast down here. Now it's literally going to scrape the coast all along Volusia, Flagler, St. John's counties. This will bring the highest storm surge, the greatest amount of damage, winds that will probably exceed over 100 miles an hour, and those will be in the gust. And keep in mind, there's your Saffir-Simpson scale. Category 4 is 130 to 156 miles an hour. It's almost inconceivable, honestly. As again, we'll have gusts up to around 175 as the storm approaches down south. This is literally what I expect to see at the height of the storm, Jacksonville Beach, Fernandina Beach, down there near Flagler Beach. When the storm moves up the coast, it will weaken, but only slightly, but 100-mile-an-hour winds will be coming onshore. The storm surge will be pushing onshore. It'll be taking out any parked cars that are sitting there on the beach, as the storm surge will be in the 7 to 8 foot range, and maybe even higher. Now, it won't be everybody's backyard, but these are for the locations that are most vulnerable. And again, this would be in through parts of St. John's all the way out towards Duval County. Now, I do think there will be places of dry land in Jacksonville Beach, so it won't all be like that. But you see those winds? They will be extremely destructive. Evacuations going on for all the barrier islands. Again, if you have the word beach in your address, it means you're going to see these kind of conditions. Wind 75 plus, that's hurricane strength, gust over 100, extensive and lengthy power outages likely. Trees will be down on many roads, widespread flooding. Again, this is all for the coastal beaches. But now I'm going to show what happens along the rivers, along Clay County, St. John's, Putnam County, north into Nassau, Camden counties. Again, the winds will be much less, the damage will be less, and again, the big waves will be out there on those rivers, and this will be a part of the coastal storm surge that'll work its way inland. It'll run about 2 to 3 feet, and again, those folks who live right along the river should evacuate their homes. Maximum river wind will be in the 55, gusting to 80 zone, and that would include downtown Jacksonville. Power outages very likely, trees down on many roads, and again, flooding. You know, when it comes to rainfall, I'm not overly concerned at this moment because of the fact that there are bigger concerns. And so it goes. Tonight, it is as ugly as it could get in terms of a forecast. I'm looking for a little ray of something. I'm hoping it'll be there when I wake up tomorrow morning. Richard will have much more on that in terms of what we might be seeing changes in the storm system. But coming up here in about 10, 15 minutes, we'll break it down a little bit more on what you can expect in your backyard as Matthew makes his big approach to Jacksonville. Rob?